session on GHB2. So we were trying to understand this coexistence in this module 4. In this session, we are trying to look into how this existence and its expression are seen by the self. So we have been saying this, that when we are going through the process of knowing, there are three things which are important. Number one, the who is the knower, what are the things to be known, and what is the process of knowing. So that we have seen that the self is the knower, and the things to be known is the whole existence. And the process is awakening to the activities of the self. There we said particularly awakening to the higher activities of the self, like contemplation, understanding, and realization. But now we will see that awakening to the activities of the self, whether it is the lower activity or the higher activity, helps us to see the reality, see the existence. So in this, after having looked into the details of coexistence and its expression, now we want to kind of correlate rather how different activities of the self helps us to see different aspects of coexistence, different aspect of different expressions of coexistence. So this we want to now see. It will be more of a collection of what we have been talking about in first course and in the second course till now. But it is important to put them together, because then it will give you an overview of how the seeing by the self and seeing of the existence of the nature is related. That we will be able to see if we try to look into this idea of how self is seeing the coexistence and its expression, how the existence, the nature is seen by the self. So let's look at that. Coexistence and its expression is seen by the self through its different activities. So this is one important statement which we'll try to unfold. So existence is in the form of coexistence, which is in the form of units submerged in space. This is what we have seen. And then we have also seen that these units, every unit has these five aspects. It has some form, some property, some natural characteristic, some uniqueness, and coexistence. These are the five aspects of any unit that we see. We had also seen that this, out of these five, this form and property are of the nature of changing, nature of variety. You see so many varieties. Right? If you look at trees, there are so many different types of trees, right? With different shape, size, color, different properties. But when you look at these natural characteristics, the innateness, the coexistence, which is basically participation in the larger order, the self-organization, the submergence, this seems to be of the nature of definiteness, continuity, and universality. So we have looked into this. We have found that these three things of an unit belonging to any of these four orders are same. The natural characteristic of the physical order is same for all units of physical order, and so is innateness. And when you look at the coexistence, it is same for all units belonging to any of the four orders. So we said that these three things, these natural characteristics of any unit, the innateness, the coexistence, they are definite, they are continuous, they are universal, right? In this, natural characteristics and innateness is same for all the units belonging to any order, any particular order. And this coexistence is same for all units belonging to any of the four orders, and all the four orders. Now we can see, and we had also said this, that these three aspects of any unit, the natural characteristic, the innateness, the coexistence, can be seen through the higher activities of the self, which is contemplation, understanding, and realization. And when we do this, what we get is what we are calling as right understanding, and this gives assurance in the self. So the major part of right understanding, the major part of knowledge, is essentially this, seeing this essence of the reality, which is definite, continuous, and universal. So this all we have seen, you know, and we are working on it. Then we have seen that this coexistence, the submergence, is seen by the self at the level of its activity of realization. This I must clarify, that when I'm saying coexistence and then I'm saying the submergence, then I'm trying to bring your attention that when we say coexistence, it is used in very general terms also. But when we are saying coexistence, submergence, it is used in a very specific term. It is used in the sense of unit submerged in space. That submergence of unit in space. So that is one thing. But when you say coexistence, it also, you know, includes many of the expressions of coexistence. So whenever I'm using it for the submergence as such, I will use this coexistence with a comma, submergence, or I will use the word submergence only. So when you look at the submergence, you know, this unit being submerged in space, then this can be seen only at the level of realization, and not at the level of lower activities of the self. So this we have stated before, but now it has to be categorically stated. Then second thing, we said the five aspects of any given unit is seen by the self through its different activities. So when it comes to the submergence, comes to the space, it has to be seen at the level of realization, the highest activity of the self. But when it comes to units, it can be seen by the self at any level of activity. Any level of activity. I can see an unit at the level of testing and selecting. I can see something, some aspect of the unit at the level of testing and selecting. Similarly, I can see some more aspects of the unit at the level of analyzing and comparing. So this is what I mentioned here, that for example, I can see the form of an unit, the shape, the size, the color of an unit at the level of selecting, testing. And of course, what we see, you know, of the form is just a part of it. So we are partly able to see the form of an unit through testing and selecting. So for example, I can see the shape of an unit For example, let's say I am seeing the shape of a ball. When I see it through eyes, do I see the complete shape or I see only the part of it? So we can only see the part which is facing our eyes. The part which is not facing our eyes or on the other side, we are not able to see. So we are able to see some part of the form, the shape of the unit through the eyes, through the testing and selecting. Similarly, when you look at the property, right, we can see some part of this property, that is the effect of one unit on another, through the activity of analyzing and comparing. So when we are working on analyzing and comparing, of course, at the base of it, some information has been derived through testing and selecting. So at the level of testing and selecting, we can see the form, some aspect of form, some part of the form. At the level of analyzing and comparing, I can see some more, that is, I can see the property of that unit, its effect on another unit. An example of this effect is that when you keep some utensil near the fire, it gets heated. This utensil is getting heated by the effect of the fire. So this is the property of the utensil, or other, from the other side, if you see, it is the property of the fire. So now if you see as to what is the meaning of to see, when I'm seeing something, what does it mean? Right. So we have the form of the unit, we have shape, size, density of unit, we have property of the unit, effect of one unit one on unit two, so the recognition and fulfillment by the unit with the unit two. And now we can see that there are three possibilities. One is seeing through sensation. Second is seeing what is rational. So this is seeing through the thought, you know, through rationality, through analyzing and comparing. And then seeing what is essential. Right. And these three things, the natural characteristics, the participation in the larger order, right, the innateness and the coexistence. So these are the three things. Now we have to see what is our level of seeing. Are we seeing only through the sensation? Are we seeing also at the level of rationality, at the level of thought, at the level of analyzing? Are we seeing at the level of seeing the essential, the natural characteristic, the innateness, the coexistence? So let us ask this to ourselves, what is our level of seeing? What does it mean for us to see? If you look at the present system of knowledge, this seems to be focused on seeing through sensation and seeing what is rational. So seeing through the rationality. So if you look at the, you know, knowledge of science, technology, any profession for that matter. It is relying on seeing through the sensation and seeing through its logic, through rationality. And if we are doing that, then we are at most able to see some aspect of the form, some part of the property. And that's it. And it tends to neglect seeing what is essence, what is definite, what is universal. So these three things that we said, this natural characteristic, the innateness, the coexistence, or in other words, the relationship, the harmony, the coexistence, we are unable to see because we have no focus on it. Our system of knowledge does not have focus on it. It is not paying attention to seeing what is essential, the definite, what is universal. So we are saying that is why we are unable to see the relationship, the harmony, the coexistence, and all this in the nature and in existence. So this is a very important thing to, you know, reflect on as to what are the possibilities of seeing by the self and what is it that we have accepted in the system of knowledge that we have today and what we have missed. So if you look at that, I've just written it down for your evaluation. The system of knowledge seems to be focused on seeing through sensation, seeing what is rational. And this is seen through the body plus the lower activities of the self. Lower activities of the self is testing, selecting, analyzing, comparing, and imaging to put them together. So this imaging, this desire, is putting them together, which can at most see the form, it, and some part of the property. That is all that we can see. But it tends to neglect seeing what is of essence, what is definite, what is universal, which is seen by the self. And if we work on this, we will be able to see this, you know, activity of contemplation, understanding, and realization in the self. And through that, we'll be able to see the relationship, the harmony, the coexistence. As a result, because we are not doing this third part, as a result, we are unable to see relationship, harmony, and coexistence around us in the nature, in existence. Rather, we may see opposition, disharmony, contradiction, and struggle. And that is what we are doing today. So this whole idea of struggle for survival, survival of the fittest, of two nations being in opposition, two families being in opposition, right? And disharmony, contradiction as the basic structure of things. All this is there because we are not able to activate our higher levels of activity like contemplation, understanding, and realization. And therefore, we are not able to see the relationship, the harmony, the coexistence. And when we are not able to see that, and if we are only seeing the form and property, then there seems to be quite the other thing, quite the opposite thing. That is, instead of relationship, we feel that there is opposition. Instead of harmony, we feel that there is contradiction. And instead of coexistence, we feel that there is struggle. And that has become our guideline, you know, basic guideline for all our perception. And if we have that as perception, the opposition, the disharmony, the struggle, then it will lead to opposition, struggle, terrorism, war, and so on, which we are seeing in, you know, ample. Majority of the nations, big nations, are spending more than 50% of their resources preparing for war. And that is just because of the limited perception of the self. So the self is looking at the existence, at nature, as people, at, you know, at the people around it, themselves, right? At the level of form and property. And when we see only at the level of form and property, we feel that we are in isolation. And many times we feel that we are in opposition. And therefore, we have to prepare how to face that opposition. So 50%, more than 50% of our resource we are willing to invest on protecting ourselves from opposition. Right? Or dominating others, which is also this form of opposition. So look at this very important thing. I will, from my side, not go into too much of detail, but if there will be any questions, I will respond to it. The majority of our problems that we see in the world today is because of lack of this perception, because of lack of this right understanding. And the major lack is in this form of not able to see what is of essence, what is definite, what is universal. Not able to see relationship, harmony, and coexistence, which can be seen only through the higher activities of the self. The contemplation, the understanding, the realization. And this is what we have been trying to look into in major part of this course, you know, in last 18 lectures. Our major focus is that we have to awaken ourselves to these higher activities of the self, this contemplation, this understanding, this realization, so that we can see the relationship, the harmony, the coexistence, which is already there in existence, which is at the base of existence. And only when we are able to see this, we'll be able to see the reality in its completeness. And this is the major part, you know, of our understanding of reality. This, if this is there at the base, then study of form and property can also be put to right utilization, put in the right place. So look into this very important thing to understand the source of problems of the world today and how to resolve it. So what we need to do is to set our system of knowledge right. Right? And how do you do it? Is to make it focused and based on seeing what is of essence, what is definite, what is universal. And this is what we are saying, in other words, what is valuable. Right? So our education, our knowledge system has to be based, focused and based on seeing what is essential, what is essence, what is definite, what is universal, what is of value, what is valuable. And if you look at that, these are the three things which is valuable: the relationship, the harmony, the coexistence, the participation in the larger order, the self-organization, the submergence. So this has to be focused and this has to be on the base of our knowledge system. And once we have this as the base of our knowledge system, then we'll be able to see the relationship, the harmony, the coexistence around us in nature and in existence. And with this, now when we look at the form and property, we can use this form and property to right use for ensuring the fulfillment of relationship, harmony, and coexistence. And this will solve many of our present day problems. So this nation spending more than 50% of their resources preparing for war can be solved if we understand that the relationship is there, the harmony is there, the coexistence is there. And if we can work for it, then in due course of time, we don't have to, you know, invest more than 50% of our resources preparing for war. And if we don't have to do that, then this 50% or more than that can be used to put to right use for, you know, feeding people, for nurturing people, for nurturing the whole nature, right, of our own nation, and also we help to other nations. So the thing of importance is this, right, to work on seeing what is of essence. And when we are working on seeing what is of essence, right, what we are trying to do is to seeing these three things. And for seeing these three things, we have to awaken to the higher activities of the self, that is contemplation, understanding, and realization. If we do that, if we focus on these higher activities of the self, to contemplation, to understanding, and realization, then we see natural characteristic, which is participation in the larger order. We see the relationship through contemplation of units, starting with one, then many, and ultimately all units. So this is one important point which we have to keep in mind, that when I'm starting, you know, I have started with testing, selecting, analyzing, comparing, and now I am moving, you know, up to the activity of contemplation. Then to begin with, I am able to see the natural characteristics of any given unit, right? The participation in the larger order, the relationship of a particular unit. Then similarly, I can look into another unit and see their participation in the larger order. So one unit, then many units, and ultimately the all units, you know, the whole nature, all units in nature. Similarly, when I'm looking at the innateness, the self-organization, the harmony of the unit through understanding of the unit, it starts with one unit, then many units, and ultimately we are able to see this innateness, this harmony of all the units in nature as a whole. So we are able to see the innateness, the harmony of all the units together, which means the harmony of the nature as a whole. And then when we are working with coexistence, we are able to see the coexistence with, through realization, the activity of realization of the self, of one and all units. Because this coexistence, this submergence is same for all units and for existence as a whole. So this is what we are able to see through contemplation, through understanding, through realization. So this is seen in a sequential manner while going from lower to higher activities. So we start with one unit, we are able to see the form, then we are able to see the property, then we are able to see the natural characteristic, then we are able to see the innateness and the coexistence. So this, I can go on building, starting with one unit, then many units, then all the units. When it comes to coexistence, I can see that this coexistence is same for all the units. So there, that unity, that, you know, commonness is quite visible. At the level of contemplation and understanding, I am able to see that there is commonness of the units at the level of different orders. So for four orders, there are four natural characteristics and four innateness. So any unit belonging to that order has this natural characteristic, has this innateness. So this is seen in a sequential manner while going from lower to higher activities. And this we will show in more detail in slide 20. However, when we are seeing from the top, that is resolution of realization of coexistence, then unfolding will be different. And it is shown in slide 21. So when we are moving, starting from testing and selecting and going up to the realization, there is one, you know, way we are following. But when we are coming from top, from realization to testing and selecting, then things will be a little different. And that we will see in slide 21. So when we are trying to work through this contemplation, understanding, and realization of the natural characteristics, the innateness, and the coexistence. Let us see what we are doing. We have already talked about it in previous sessions, but I am recalling them for your ready reference. So use them as reference. We will not get into the details or description of it. So we saw that this four orders in nature can be seen in the form of different units, right? In the form of how this submergence, this coexistence is reflecting itself at the level of that order. What is the innateness of that order, the natural characteristic of that order, the activity of that order, and the inheritance of that order. So these descriptions, the six different descriptions of an unit belonging to the physical order is given, and we have studied this in the last few sessions. So I will not go into the detailed explanation of it, but the important conclusion that we want to draw out of this is that when we are looking at this level of submergence of the unit belonging to that order, right, this basically is the realization. So realization of coexistence, of submergence, of unit submerged in space. This is what we are able to see at the level of realization. At the level of understanding, we are able to see the innateness, the self-organization of the unit. We are able to see that this unit is self-organized in space. And at the level of natural characteristics, at the level of contemplation, we are able to see the natural characteristics of the unit. We are able to see, recognize its relationship with other unit and fulfill its relationship with every other unit in space. So through realization, we are able to see the submergence, the coexistence. Through understanding, we are able to see the innateness, and through contemplation, we are able to see the natural characteristics. And if you look at the details of this, we can see what is the details of submergence in each order, what is the details of innateness of each order, and what is the details of natural characteristics of each order. That we have already described before. But what we are trying to bring to your notice is that through these activities of the self, the activity of contemplation, understanding, and realization, we will be able to see the natural characteristic, the innateness, the submergence. We will be able to see its relationship, harmony, and coexistence. So basically, through contemplation, we'll have the clarity of relationship, of natural characteristics of participation in the larger order. Through understanding, we'll be able to ensure harmony in nature, the self-organization, the unit innateness. So harmony of every unit and ultimately the whole nature, the self-organization, the innateness of every unit and ultimately the whole nature. And similarly, through the realization, we can ensure the clarity of coexistence in existence, clarity about the submergence. So this is what we can do through the higher activities of the self, which presently we are not doing. We are not focusing on it. Therefore, we are not able to see the relationship, the harmony, the coexistence. And we have seen what is the implication of it. And the important and interesting thing is that when we look at this, the coexistence or submergence, okay, and innateness and natural characteristics, particularly for human being, then it becomes very important. Because when you look at the first three orders, this coexistence, this innateness, this natural characteristic is all there and the units are going with it. But when it comes to human being, at the level of body, things are going well. At the level of self, a part of it is realized and part of it has to be realized through our own effort. So that becomes important. Understanding my submergence, understanding my innateness, understanding my natural characteristics makes all the difference for me. Because depending upon that understanding, I will be able to see it and I will be thinking in terms of working for it. So if I have not seen it, I have not understood it, then I don't pay attention to it. I don't work for it. And therefore, I don't ensure that development in myself. So if you look at this lower one, at the level of submergence, in the self we have the sensitivity and we have the possibility of knowability. Mostly we are working with the first one, the sensitivity part. And we are not paying much attention to the knowability. So that yellow part, we are active, sensitivity in I. This violet part, we are not active, knowability in the self. Right. But the potential is there, the possibility is there, it has to be realized. And only when we pay attention to it and we work on it and we realize it, right, we can fulfill our process of development, process of unfolding, process of ensuring this continuous happiness, which is the innateness of the self. So you can see that the submergence of the self is not seen, not understood, therefore we are not paying attention to it. Therefore our process of development, evolution is not completed. Similarly, at the level of innateness, we can see that we have come to see that we need to live with continuous happiness. But we are not able to see how this is ensured through right understanding, right feeling and right thought. So we have the potentiality to see this and realize this. Right? But that is possible only when we start looking deeper into ourselves and see that our innateness is to have right understanding, to have right feeling and right thought. And on the basis of it, to live with continuous happiness. Similarly, with this investigation into natural characteristics, we can see that our natural characteristics is for perseverance, bravery, generosity, and so on till compassion. So if we are able to look at it through contemplation, then we will develop this, natural characteristics, this participation in the larger order in terms of perseverance, in terms of bravery, in terms of kindness, and so on. And similarly, at the level of activity, we can see that we have potential for understanding, but we are busy only with imagination, with thought. So this is slide 20 and 21, where we are trying to discuss what is happening when we are going from lower activity to the higher activity, and from the higher activity to the lower activity. So this description is about going from lower activity of the self to higher activity of the self. So just a brief description is given and you can start looking at it and start working on it. Of course, when you start working on it, there'll be many questions, right, which we will, keep responding time to time. So if you start with selecting and testing, we are able to see some part of the form. For example, shape, size, color, and some part of the property of the unit. At the level of analyzing and comparing, we are able to see some part of the property of the unit, that is the effect of one unit on another unit. So this is what we are able to see. if we are moving from the lower activity to the higher activity. When we move up to the contemplation, there is a possibility of getting the clarity of relationship of natural characteristics of participation in the larger order. Right. So this possibility is there and we start working on it. Then we may get some part of this clarity. It may or may not be, you know, the complete. In fact, it is not complete until we have this base of realization of coexistence. So till then, we have the feel, we have some sense of it, but that deep assurance is not there. And we are able to see the relationship, the natural characteristics of those units only which we are paying attention to. And there are many units in the nature, in existence, which are left out. Right. So suppose we are paying attention to a unit belonging to physical order, then we'll be able to see and get some feel about the participation of that unit in the larger order. Right. But it will not mean that I am able to see this participation for all the units belonging to all other orders. Similarly, when we move up to understanding, we are able to have the clarity of harmony of the units, the self-organization, the innateness of the unit to begin with. So this is also part, you know, kind of clarity. And it is slowly building up from one unit to many units and ultimately the whole nature. And when we go up to this realization, there it is the same for all units. So every unit is submerged in space. So when I'm able to realize this unit being submerged in space, this realization is the realization of submergence, of coexistence of this particular unit, but it is the same for all unit. So ultimately, I can see the whole nature, I can see all the units, and I can see that all units are submerged in space. And that is what we are calling as realization, submergence of unit in space, of one, of many, and of all the units. So this is what is going to happen when we are moving up from lower activity to the higher activity. So I've just given some hint, you know, about how it seems to be working. And this is something which I'm myself working on it. And I am placing this as a proposal so that you also can investigate and we can investigate and explore together and evolve in the process. Similarly, when we are looking from top to down, you know, starting from realization of coexistence, then things will be different. Different in the sense that now we have the realization of coexistence, realization of the submergence, realization of units submerged in space, which is, you know, complete thing in itself. And now in the light of this realization of coexistence, when we are coming down, we are able to see the harmony in nature, the self-organization, the innateness of the nature as a whole. And then of course, the self-organization of every unit in this nature. And this is supported by that assurance, deep assurance that everything is in coexistence. Everything is in harmony. So not that I have to make harmony, I have to create harmony, right? But there is coexistence, there is harmony, and every unit is in harmony in space. I only have to understand it and be with it. So now I am able to see that there is harmony in every unit, and this harmony is in the context of the harmony in the entire nature, in the context of coexistence and existence. Similarly, when I come down to the level of contemplation, now I am able to see the natural characteristic, the participation of the unit in larger order at the level of whole nature, the level of all the units in nature. So now I can see that this relationship that I see of given unit with other unit is in fact, you know, founded by the relationship of all units with all units, and founded by every unit being in harmony and coexistence in space. So that definiteness is there, that universality is there, that continuity is there in our, in what we see. And with this clarity of coexistence, harmony, and relationship, now I am able to see how I can relate to the world outside. How I can relate to the world outside. So my analyzing and comparing of my fulfillment, recognition and fulfillment of relationship is now guided by coexistence, harmony and relationship, which I have seen at the level of higher activities. And this is also guiding my senses, guiding my health, guiding my profit. So now my perception about the health, the senses, the profit, is guided by my clarity about coexistence, harmony, and relationship. And similarly, when I am looking at the level of testing and selecting, while I am focusing on the property, on the form, on the fulfillment of this relationship, you know, with the world outside, this testing, this selecting is now guided by this coexistence, the harmony, the relationship. And I'm using the senses or sensation for the purpose of ensuring harmony, ensuring relationship, ensuring coexistence. So the sensation is now rightly utilized, that we have discussed, that right utilization of sensation is to ensure nurturing of the body, protection of the body, right utilization of the body, and also for sharing our knowledge and our feeling with other human beings. So now sensation is not just used for getting some temporary happiness out of it, some excitement out of it, but now it is used in the light of coexistence, harmony, and relationship. So it is, you know, used for the purpose of ensuring all this. So sensation is also, you know, placed in the context of this higher, you know, activity, in the context of this basic essential reality, that is relationship, harmony, and coexistence. And of course, with this, if this is what is happening at the level of self, my behavior, my work, my participation will be reflected, will reflect all this outside. But I'm not going into that detail. So this is what is going to happen when I have reached to the top of the activity of self, that is realization of coexistence, and coming down from there. So this is again just trying to place all things in, you know, place all things together so that you can start looking at it, start working on it, and if we are able to get a feel of it, then it will help us to get better organized within the self and also to work further for our self-evolution. With this, another thing which I want to place before I open to question is that with this kind of understanding, with this kind of, you know, of trying to work on it, now let us see that when we look at this submergence, this coexistence, this submergence, and when we look at the space, what do we see? What is seen by the self? When it is looking into this submergence and looking into the space. So some of the questions which came just before this session started was basically in relation to this, that when I see something, I see the form of it. I see the property of it. Why do I have to go up to the higher activity? Particularly, why do I have to go up to the realization? Why do I have to see the space? What is the importance of it? And the response that I gave was that if you have not evolved to higher activities of the self, you will, you know, not see the, you will not see the importance of, you know, working with these higher activities. So at least you have to get some feel of it. So with that in mind, we are trying to just describe that when we are looking at the submergence, right, what it will be seen as at the level of different activities of the self. This is important because this will give us an idea about how we are perceiving the submergence, how we are perceiving the space, right? And depending upon that, whether it seems to be important for us or not important for us. So we are saying coexistence and space is seen differently by various activities of self. So now we want to understand how coexistence, the submergence, is seen by the self and how space is seen by the self, depending upon activation of its higher and higher activities. So let us look at that. If we are looking at the level of activity of selecting and testing, then this coexistence, the submergence, is seen as two units with gap, with void in between. So this coexistence, the submergence, is seen as two units with gap in between. So I see the unit with the void, with the gap, with the absence. Now, if we are looking at it at the level of analyzing and comparing also, then we see the unit, two units, with effect of one unit on another. So when we were seeing at the level of selecting and testing, we were only able to see the gap, the void, the absence between two units. Now we are able to see that there are some effects also, you know, of one unit on the other unit. When we are able to see that there is some effect, right, then we start getting a feel that this space in between is not just the absence. So if I can see that the heat of sun is reaching the earth, our body, so there is some effect of the sun on my body, right? Then it starts giving some feel that this space in between is not just the absence, right? So this is getting a feel that space is something, maybe very, you know, something important, but it is not something which is just the absence. Now, what we are saying is that if we start looking at the level of contemplation, then not only that we see that there is some effect, but we are able to see that there is relationship of one unit with another unit in space. And out of this relationship, there is some effect of one unit on the other unit. So this is more, you know, kind of a stronger condition, that not only that there is some effect of one unit on another unit, but there is relationship between one unit and another unit. So So now this coexistence is seen as relationship between units. And we can also correlate that this relationship is what leads to the effect upon unit analysis. If you go still higher at the level of understanding, we are able to see the harmony, the self-organization of every unit. So not only that this unit is in relationship with other unit in space, but it is in state of harmony, state of self-organization in space. And when we move still higher to the activity of realization, we are able to see that this unit is submerged in space. So I'm not only seeing the unit and its harmony, I'm able to see the unit, its harmony, and I'm able to see this unit in space, in coexistence in space, in submergence in space. So this is how I start, you know, when I work with myself and start looking at the coexistence, you know, at higher and higher level of activities, I am able to see better and better, you know, part of this coexistence. And at the level of realization, I am able to see the submergence of the unit in space. We are able to see the submergence as such. So this is how we will see the coexistence. At the level of testing selecting, we'll see the coexistence as two units with gap, with void, with absence. At the level of realization, ultimately we will see that this all units are in space, all units are submerged in space. So this submergence is there. The whole nature is submerged in space. So this is how we will be able to unfold our understanding, our clarity, our perception of coexistence. So this is how the coexistence is seen. Now, if you look at the space, then space is seen differently through different activities. Through the selecting and testing, this space is seen as a void, as an absence. At the level of analyzing and comparing, it is seen as a medium for transfer effect. At the level of contemplation, now we are able to see that it is a reality in which relationship is ensured. So very important. Now space is not seen as an absence. Right. But it is seen as a reality in which relationship between any two units is ensured. At the level of understanding, now I can see that this is a reality in which harmony is ensured. And at the level of realization, I can see that this space is a reality in which submergence is ensured, coexistence is ensured. So now I can see how important this space is. And it is not just an absence. It is a reality. And it is a reality in which the harmony of the unit is ensured. The relationship between unit is ensured. The submergence of the unit in space is ensured. So probably it is the most important reality, right, in which all units are energized. All units are self-organized. All units are recognizing their relationship with other unit and fulfilling it. So it is this space which is providing the base, which is providing the foundation for all units to be there, to be active, to be in harmony, to be in relationship. So not only that we have to focus on units, we also have to focus on the space. We have to focus on coexistence of unit in space, the submergence. We have to focus on units being in harmony in space. We have to focus on unit being in relationship with other units in space. So this is what has to be our focus. Then we'll be able to see the coexistence, the harmony, the relationship. We'll be able to understand the existence as a whole outside perspective. We'll be able to understand the nature as a whole. We'll be able to understand ourselves as a unit in nature. And we'll be able to understand our relationship with this whole nature, with this whole existence. And if we can see this, then we can fulfill our role, our participation in this nature, in this existence, in a manner which is fulfilling for us as human beings, and which is fulfilling for the whole nature, for all the units in nature. This will also help the process of unfolding of coexistence, which is already taking place, and help in completing this process of unfolding of coexistence that we have seen, we have talked about in the past. But now we will do talk about this, in the light of this discussion now, that how with this understanding of coexistence, understanding of harmony in nature, and my being in this nature, I can decide my participation, my role, and fulfill that role. And what will be the result of it? What will be the impact of it, in my own self and in the nature around? So that we'll take up in the next few sessions. So with this, I think I will stop my kind of presentation. I will just briefly mention about some of these points for self-reflection and then open the question. So let's look at these points for self-reflection. Investigate into your natural characteristics, innateness, and coexistence. So you are being in relationship, being in harmony, being in coexistence. Right. That is feelings in relationship, the state of happiness, the submergence in space. So this point for self-reflection was given before also, but it is replaced here to recall that now you can do the same thing much better now. Second is investigate whether your living is centered around the activities of selecting, testing, analyzing, comparing, imaging, contemplation, and so on. So most of us must be living at one of these levels, right? Just selecting, testing, or over and above selecting, testing, we have analyzing and comparing, and so on. So you find out for yourself what is your living centered around. Around which activity. Third is consider any unit and try to see all five aspects of that unit. So we said five aspects are there in every unit. So you select any unit and look at these five aspects, form, property, etc. Which are the different aspects you are able to see at present? Also try to observe the activity of the self that is involved in seeing. So presently, what aspects are of importance for you? Which means what aspects are you able to see through your activity of the self? Fourth is investigate whether you are able to see the coexistence, submergence, until which level of activity of the self. So you are able to see the coexistence, the submergence, right? Either as a you know, gap between two units with gap is wide, or all units submerged in space, the whole range is there that we have just mentioned. So find out what you are able to see when you are looking at the coexistence and submergence. And also find out how do you see the space. Right? How do you see the space? And that will tell you up to what level of activity of the self you are awakened. Right? So look into these points, important points for you to reflect on.